100 years ago, Britain's greatest national event was stopped in its tracks by a very public, very shocking, fatal act of protest. At the height of the 1913 Epsom Derby, in front of thousands of spectators, a lone figure walked into the path of the galloping horses. What happened next was captured on film in horrific detail. The woman in this footage was Emily Wilding Davison.
She was a suffragette, and she climbed underneath the running rail into the path of the King's horse.
June the 4th, 1913. The biggest event of the lot was Derby Day. Hundreds of thousands of people headed for Epsom Downs. It was one of the few occasions where all social classes mixed together. Dukes rubbed shoulders with dustmen. Royalty was separated from the hoi polloi by just the width of a racetrack. The King and Queen arrived to see their horse, Anma, in the big race. Emily knew that the eyes of the world and the lenses of the newsreel cameraman would be focused on Epsom. It transformed 40-year-old activist Emily Davison from a bit part player in the Votes for Women campaign into perhaps the most famous suffragette of all. Emily joined the suffragettes in 1906, just as the organisation was becoming more radical. In 1908, she was a marshal at a protest in Hyde Park that attracted as many as 700,000 people. In 1909, she was arrested for trying to storm the House of Commons. She was now part of a large network of freelance militants engaged in repeated acts of criminality. Suffragette militancy was now seen as a real threat to society. The government imprisoned more than 1,000 militant suffragettes. Emily Davison went to prison 9 times for her cause, for offences that ranged from breaking windows to firebombing letterboxes. Now, a new militancy that included fire-raising and bombings was seen as the only answer. The radicals felt they had nothing to lose. Violent militancy escalated. After 9 prison sentences, weakened by hunger striking and 49 episodes of force feeding, Emily was perhaps coming to believe that one final desperate act might produce a result. Now, with a prison record, she was broke and unemployable. A radicalised woman with nothing to lose, championing a cause with everything to gain, was about to commit an act that would be seared into our social history. On Derby Day, June the 4th, 1913, a horrifying act was captured on 3 newsreel cameras. After 100 years, it might be possible to reveal what Emily's intentions actually were. Using the 3 camera angles, the team has pinpointed Emily's position on the course. This introduces an intriguing possibility. Emily had only 4 seconds between ducking under the rail and being bowled over. Our forensic examination has highlighted something in her hands that provides an explanation. She wasn't trying to bring down the king's horse at all. She was hoping to attach something to it. A scarf. Emily Davison's death provoked a complex reaction. I've come to the Women's Library to look at the hate mail Emily received while she lay dying. Miss Davison, I am glad to hear you are in hospital. I hope you suffer torture until you die, you idiot, underlined. I consider you are a person unworthy of existence in this world and should like the opportunity of starving and beating you to a pulp. Why don't your people find an asylum for you? Yours, an Englishman. Emily was taken to the Cottage Hospital in Epsom. She never came out of the coma into which she had fallen, and she died 4 days later. The coroner's verdict was accidental death. Her funeral contained all the pomp of a state occasion. Thousands of suffragettes accompanied the coffin. Tens of thousands of people lined the streets of London. Emily had become what she perhaps desired and what the movement needed, the first martyr for the cause.
Oh,